morning. Well, as I was introduced as Mike McCloskey, yes, I'm Irish. How many Irish do we have in the room today? Raise them up high. Well, like it or not, we're all Irish, at least for today anyway, right? I'm going to start with a song. It's about the River Liffey. Now, the River Liffey runs through counties Wicklow, Dublin, and Kildare, and into the Irish Sea, which is on the east coast of Ireland. Ireland's recession some years ago affected the ferry boats and the ferry boat captains on the River Liffey. This story is going to tell you a little bit about a ferry boat captain that lost his job, but it has a good ending, so it goes like this. Boats are gone from the breast of Anna Liffey. The ferrymen are stranded on the quay. The Dublin docks are dying, and our way of life is gone. And Molly, it was part of you and me. Where the strawberry beds sweep down to the Liffey, kiss away the worries from my brow. I love you more today, and I love you more tomorrow. If you ever loved me, Molly, love me now. 'Twas the only job I knew. It was hard, but never lonely. The Liffey Ferry made a man of me. Now it's gone without a whisper, forgotten even now. And it's over, Molly, over, can't you see? Where the strawberry beds sweep down to the Liffey, kiss away the worries from my brow. I love you more today, and I'll love you more tomorrow. If you ever love me, Molly, love me now. Spin my yarn, I spend my day talking. They're whispering, Charlie's on the door. Oh, but Molly, we're still living, and darling, we're still young. And the river never ruled my heart and soul. Where the strawberry beds sweep down to the Liffey, you kiss away the worries from my brow. I love you more today, I love you more tomorrow. If you ever love me, Molly, love me now. Now if you ever love me, Molly, love me now. Thank you, folks. You know what, we did pass out some lyrics to a few of these Irish tunes. So I really invite you to help me out here. I don't want to be singing alone all day today. All right? So we're going to start with Tura Lura Lura, number one, first page. And then we're going to go right into My Wild Irish Rose. By the way, My Wild Irish Rose was written around 1899 or so.
I pretend to be.
So I'm just going to start singing, and come on, join me in. Tooralooralooral, tooralooralooral, tooralooralooralooral. don't you cry. Tooraloo-ra-loo-ra. It's an Irish lullaby. My wild Irish rose, the sweetest flower that grows. You can look anywhere, and none can compare to my wild Irish rose. Irish rose, the dearest flower that grows. And someday for my sake, in England we take the bloom from my wild Irish rose. Thank you, folks. Who can tell me what a unicorn is? It is. It's a mythical, what is it? A mythical creature. Anybody know what it looks like? The horn on the head. Looks like a horse. The unicorn. The Irish Rovers wrote, well, they didn't write it, but they recorded it over in Ireland. And Irish Rovers, one of my favorite Irish groups. So if you, I think that's on page 2, isn't it? There's the chorus. So I'm going to just start singing this song and join in on the chorus if you like. I'll sing the verses. You remember that guy Noah? You know, the Lord looked down on Noah and said, build me an ark because it's going to rain for 40 days and 40 nights. You remember that guy? That's what this song is about. Kind of. Well, a long time ago when the earth was green, there were more kinds of animals than you've ever seen. They roamed free while the earth was being born. The loveliest of all was the unicorn. Here we go. And there were green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpy-backed camels and chimpanzees, cats and rats and elephants, as sure as you're born, the loveliest of all was the unicorn. Now, the Lord seen some sinning and it gave him pain. And he said, stand back, I'm gonna make it rain. He said, hey Noah, tell you what to do. Build me a floating zoo and gather green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpy-backed camels and chimpanzees, cats and rats and elephants, as sure as you're born, the loveliest of all was the unicorn. Now, old Noah was there to answer the call. He finished up the ark just as the rain started to fall. He gathered up the animals two by two and hollered as they came through. Hey Lord, I've got green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpy-backed camels and chimpanzees, cats and rats and elephants, as sure as you're born. But Lord, I can't find no unicorns. Now this is what happened next. The ark started moving and it drifted with the tide. The unicorns looked up from their rocks and they cried. The rain came falling and gently floated them away. That's why you don't see unicorns to this very day. And there were green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpy-backed camels and chimpanzees, cats and rats and elephants, as sure as you're born, the loveliest of all was the unicorn. Anybody know how Ireland got its name? Whiskey? Well, maybe that was part of it. Well, let me tell you. Have you ever heard the story of how Ireland got its name? I will tell you so you'll understand, for whence old Ireland came. Sure, a little bit of heaven fell from up the sky one day, and it nestled in the ocean in a spot so far away. And when the angels found it, for it looked so sweet and fair, they said, suppose we leave it, for it looks so peaceful there. So they sprinkled it with stardust just to make the shamrocks grow. 'Tis the only place you'll find them, no matter where you go. Then they dotted it with silver just to make its lake so grand. And when they had it finished, sure they called it Ireland. Summer's gone, and all the leaves have fallen. 'Tis you, it's you, must go, and I must bide. So come ye back to summers in the meadow, or in the valleys lush and white with snow. Yes, I'll be there in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so. Thank you, folks. Do you want to hear a story about St. Patrick? Who wants to hear it? I don't want to make it too long, but, you know, there's a lot to tell about this guy. And, well, I'll just go ahead here. First of all, where was St. Patrick born? Anybody? Okay, I heard Ireland, I heard England, and I heard Germany. The answer, England. Yes, you're the one. Give her a hand. Yes. St. Patrick, the patron saint of Ireland, is one of Christianity's most widely known figures. But for all his celebrity, his life remains somewhat of a mystery. Many of the stories traditionally associated with St. Patrick, including the famous account of his banishing of all the snakes from Ireland, are false. the products of hundreds of years of exaggerated storytelling. And some of you may know that Irish are known for story and joke telling, right? It is known that St. Patrick was born in Britain to wealthy parents near the end of the 4th century. He was believed to have died on March 17th, around 460 AD. There is no evidence that Patrick came from a particularly religious family. At the age of 16, Patrick was taken prisoner by a group of Irish raiders who were attacking his family's estate. They transported him to Ireland, where he spent 6 years in captivity. During this time, he worked as a shepherd, outdoors, and away from people. Lonely and afraid, he turned to his religion for solace, became a devout Christian, and it is also believed that Patrick first began to dream of converting the Irish people to Christianity during his captivity. After more than 6 years as a prisoner, Patrick escaped. According to his writing, a voice which he believed to be God's spoke to him in a dream, telling him it was time to leave Ireland. To do so, Patrick walked nearly 200 miles from County Mayo. And I have a small map here. This is I know it's small. It's Ireland though, but if you look, let's see. On the right, my right side, your left side, that's where he started, on the western side of Ireland. And he walked 200 miles, and that's about what the distance is from the east, west coast to the east coast in Ireland. So he walked all that way. And it's believed he was held to the Irish coast. After escaping to Britain, Patrick reported that he experienced a second revelation. An angel in a dream tells him to return to Ireland as a missionary. Soon after, Patrick began religious training, a course of study that lasted more than 15 years. After he was ordained as a priest, he was sent back to Ireland with a dual mission, to minister to Christians already living in Ireland and to begin to convert the Irish. Familiar with the Irish language and culture, Patrick chose to incorporate traditional ritual into his lessons of Christianity. For instance, he superimposed a sun, a powerful Irish symbol, onto the Christian cross to create what is now called the Celtic cross. You see it? Yeah. My wife and I took a couple of trips to Ireland, and there are a lot of headstones with this Celtic cross on it. So that respect of the symbol would soon be more natural to the Irish, which brings us to the Celtic cross. And I'm going to read a little bit about it. The Celtic cross is widely used as a Christian symbol, but as we can tell from its name, the cross has a history of stretching back further back than Christianity, over 2,500 years. Its four arms are interpreted as the four elements: earth, air, fire, water. The four directions of the compass: north, south, east, west. Or the four parts of man and woman: mind, soul, heart, body, in various cultures. St. Patrick superimposed the circle to represent the sun, which was a powerful Irish symbol. To some Irish Catholics, the circle can represent Christ's halo. That's the Celtic cross. And with that, I'm going to do a sea shanty song. Anybody know what a sea shanty song is? Well, here's one. Way up she rises, way up she rises, way up. morning up, she rises early in the morning. What do you with a drunken sailor? What do you do with a drunken sailor? What do you do with a drunken sailor early in the morning? This is where that whiskey part comes in. Stick on his back a mustard plaster. Stick on his back a mustard plaster. Stick on his back a mustard plaster early in the morning. Give him a dose of salt and water. Give him a dose of salt and water. Give him a dose of salt and water early in the morning. What do you do with a drunken sailor? What do you do with a drunken sailor? What do you do with a drunken sailor early in the morning? When up she rises, when up she rises, when up she rises early in the morning. Take him and shake him and try and wake him. Take him and shake him and try and wake him. Take him and shake him and try and wake him. Early in the morning. Yeah. Now this is my favorite one. This is the last one. Soak him in oil till he sprouts a flipper. Soak him in oil till he sprouts a flipper. Soak him in oil till he sprouts a flipper. Early in the morning. That's what you do with a drunken sailor. That's what you do with a drunken sailor. That's what you do with a drunken sailor. Early in the morning. I know we have at least one Scottish person in the room. Would you mind raising your hand? Yes. This next song has two titles. It has an Irish title, Wild Mountain Time. It has a Scottish title, Go Lassie Go. Now both countries claim that they own this song. So you can bet there was probably a little bit of arm wrestling going on. Anyway, I'm Irish, Wild Mountain Time. Oh, the summer time is coming, and the trees are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain time grows around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go? And we'll all go together to pull wild mountain time all around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go? I will build my love a bower near yon pure and crystal fountain, and on it I will pile all the flowers of the mountain. Will you go, lassie, go? And we'll now go together to pull wild mountain time all around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go? If my true love she be gone, I will not find another to pull wild mountain time all around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go? and we'll all go together to Poor Wild Mountain Time, all around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go? Oh, the autumn time has come, and the leaves are gently falling, and the wild mountain thyme grows around the purple heather. Will you go, lassie, go? And we'll all go together to Poor Wild Mountain Thyme, all around the purple heather. Will you go, lassie, go? Get off the Irish for a little bit here, and we're going to go to Hawaii. Okay? You know, they do celebrate St. Patrick's Day in Hawaii, last I heard. So, this is a song where I'm going to sing a line, and then you have to sing that line back to me, okay? Are you ready?
Yeah.
You sure? Are you ready?
Yeah!
C&H,
pure cane sugar,
from Hawaii, growing in the sun. C&H,
pure cane sugar,
from Hawaii, you're the one. Tiny bubbles
in the wine
makes me happy,
makes me feel fine.
Tiny bubbles makes me warm all over, and I feel like I'm gonna love you till the end of time. One more verse. Tiny bubbles,
tiny bubbles
in the beer,
in the beer
makes me happy,
makes me happy.
I'll tell you what, 2022 is gonna be a much better year.
Yeah.
Tiny bubbles makes me warm all over, and I feel like I'm gonna love you till the end of time. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Second verse. The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken. So I hung my head and I cried. First verse. You are my
sunshine.
You'll never Sunshine away. Sing that part again. Please don't take my sunshine away. Sing it one more time and watch me. Wow, I got you all. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Question for the day.
Who could tell me the difference between an Irish jig and an Irish reel? Anybody? By the way, anybody know what this is? It's baby powder. More than one use, you know. Okay, I'll tell you the difference between an Irish jig and an Irish reel. An Irish jig is, in music terms, 6/8 time. Yes. So when I talk about 6/8 time, think about the word strawberry. Okay, so I'm going to do a little rhythm here on 6/8 time. Strawberry, 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 strawberry. This is an Irish reel. That is 4/4 time, common. Most of the songs you hear, like on the radio or whatever, 4/4 time. Irish reel is like this. Think of the word rutabaga. Rutabaga, 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 rutabaga. Now I'm going to play a song that goes back to the Irish jig. You've probably heard this a million times. I'll do it. Here it goes. And though we're small in number, we're the best in all the land. Of course, I'm the conductor, and I've had the privilege to play with all the fine musicians that you read about today. Whoa, the drums they play, the cymbals clang, the horns they blaze away. McCarthy puffs the old bassoon, and Doyle his pipes display. Hennessy toodly toots the flute, the music is something grand, and it's a tribute to good old Ireland's boys and McNamara's band. Hey! It's an annual celebration, all the gentry will be there. The boys and girls will sing their songs, the music is something grand. It's a tribute to good old Ireland's boys and McNamara's band. And sitting in the front row will be McNamara's band.
Hey!
This is an Irish reel, 4/4 time. Rutabaga, rutabaga, rutabaga. As I was crossing over the Fairbank Kerry Mountain, I met Captain Farrell and his money he was counting. I first produced my pistol, I then produced my rep. You were saying, stand and deliver, for you are a bold deceiver. Marsha, ring, rum-a-doo, rum-a-da. Whack for the daddy-o, whack for the daddy-o, there's whiskey in the jar. I counted out his money, it was a pretty penny. Put it in my pocket and I took it home to Jenny. She sighed, then she said that she never would deceive me. But the devil take women, for they never can be easy. Musha, ring, rum-a-doo, rum-a-da. Quack for the daddy-o, quack for the daddy-o, there's whiskey in the jar. I went into my chamber for to make a slumber. I dreamed gold and silver and was sure it was no wonder. Then Jenny took my pistols, then filled them what with water, and sent for Captain Farrell to be ready for the slaughter. Musha, ring, rum-a-doo, rum-a-da. Quack for the daddy-o, quack for the daddy-o, there's whiskey in the jar. Now if anyone can save me, it's my brother in the army. If I can find his station in Cork or in Killarney, and if he'll go with me, we'll go roaming in Kilkenny. He'll treat me better than my two-time in Chenny. Musha, ring, rum-a-doo, rum-a-da. Whack for the daddy-o, whack for the daddy-o, there's whiskey in the jar. Whack for the daddy-o, whack for the daddy-o, there's whiskey in the jar. In Dublin's fair city, where girls are so pretty, I first set my eyes on Miss Molly Malone. She pushed her wheelbarrow down streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh. She was a fishmonger, 'twas no wonder that so were her mother and father before. They pushed their wheelbarrow down streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh. Now Molly died from the fever, and no one could save her. And that was the end of Miss Molly Malone. But Molly's ghost pushed her wheelbarrow down streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, crying cockles and muscles, alive, alive, oh. Who's the man in black, folks? Yeah, well, he sang a few Irish tunes, but this one is, this isn't one. I hear the train a-coming, rolling around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. And when I hear that whistle blowing all down to San Antone, when I was just a baby, Mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. Well, I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. Oh my, when I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. Well, just because you think that you're so pretty, and just because you think that you're so high, just because you think you've got something that nobody else has got, well, you smile and make me spend all my money. Call me old Santa Claus. Well, I'm telling you, baby, I'm through with you. Because, just because. So pretty, you can clap your hands. Just because you think that you're so hot, and just because you think you got something that nobody else has got, well, you smile and make me spend all my money, and you laugh and call me old Santa Claus. Well, I'm telling you, baby, I'm through with you, because just be. Just because. Go to the last page of your handout, please. I'm going to sing the first part, and then let's all sing this second part, which you have. There's a tear in your eye, and I'm wondering why, for there never should be one at all. For the power in your smile, sure the stone you beguile, and never a teardrop will fall. With the sweet lilting laughter like some fairy song, and your eyes sure as bright as can be. You can laugh all the while, and all other times smile, smile, smile for me. When Irish eyes are smiling, sure is like a morning spring. In the lilt of Irish laughter, you can hear the angels sing. When Irish hearts are happy, all the world is bright and gay. For when Irish eyes are smiling, sure they steal. We've got time for about 1 1/4 more songs here. Then we're going to line up for some corned beef and cabbage. Is that right? You know, this is a Scots-Irish kind of a tune. You know, the Scots brought this kind of music over to the East Coast, and there's that Irish feel to it. And, we picked it up as bluegrass. And Bill Monroe did this song. It's one of these songs where I'm going to sing two words, and you're not going to sing those two words back to me. You're going to yell them. Okay? So, if I sing, y'all come, what are you going to yell?
Y'all come. Woo!
Remember, you got to yell it. When you live in the country, everybody is your neighbor. There's one thing you can rely, that when they come to see you, they never ever leave you, saying, y'all come to see us by and by. Here we go. Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come to see us now and then. Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come.
See us when you can. Now, kinfolk are coming, and they're coming by the dozen, and they're eating everything from soup to hay. But then after dinner, they ain't looking any thinner, but y'all come to see us anyway. Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Well, y'all come to see us now and then. Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come,
y'all come.
Well, y'all come to see us when you can. One more verse. Now, Grandma's in the kitchen, and she's a-wishing some help with the dishes right away. But when she sees you leaving, Grandma stops her grieving, says, you all come to see me any day. Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Come to see us now and then. Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Y'all come.
Will y'all come to see us when you can? I have one little bit of song I'd like to sing for you, and then we can go ahead and line up, I guess, for the luncheon. This song was recorded by the Clancy Brothers from Ireland, along with Tommy Makem. They used to pair up and record together. It's also recorded by Bob Dylan, but I'm going to do one verse. With your permission. Oh, all the money that I've spent, I have spent it in good company, and all the harm e'er I have done, at last was done to none but me. For all I've done, for want of wit, to memory now I can't recall. So fill to me the parting glass. Good day and joy be with you all. Good day.